Creating an export of your Blackboard Learn course content. What is a course export and when should you create one? An export is a backup of all of the content and materials in your Blackboard course, but it does not contain any student data. You must create your export at the beginning of the semester after you've made any necessary updates to your course, but before any course sections are canceled or reassigned. This is very important because if you do not create your export before a course is canceled or reassigned, you will lose access to your content and it cannot be retrieved in Blackboard. A course export doesn't contain student data, so there are no student privacy concerns, but ideally you should store the exported zip file that you download from Blackboard securely on your college's network. How to export a course. First, log into Blackboard Learn. You can see I've already done that. Next, click on the course that you wish to export. When the course opens, be sure that edit mode is turned on. Scroll down below the course menu to the area labeled Course Management. Below that, click on Packages and Utilities. In the expanded menu, click Export Archive Course. On the Export Archive Course page, select the Export Package tab. In the File Attachments section, be sure that you leave all of the default settings, as shown. Under the Select Course Materials area, click Select All. Blackboard will only export what you are actually using in your course. Then, click the Submit button. Once you click Submit, you're going to see a purple bar appear up at the top of your screen, and this indicates that the action has been queued. An email will be sent to your college email address when the process is complete. If Blackboard is really busy, it could take up to an hour to finish. Please do not submit a second time. Once you have received the email, you're going to repeat the original steps. You're going to go into your course, and then you will go down to Course Management and select Export Archive Course, and then click the Refresh button. When you click Refresh, you will see a link to your export file. Now you're ready to download this export zip file from your Blackboard course to your own computer. To do this, simply click on the name of the file. What happens next is going to change a little bit depending upon the web browser that you're using. I'm using Firefox, and so I have an option to actually save the file. You do not want to open it. You never want to open it because you're not going to see anything if you open up this zip file. You can't do anything with it. It can only be restored back into Blackboard. So I'm going to click Save File, and then I'm going to click OK. By default, this should go into the Downloads folder on your own computer. So I'm going to click OK, and then I'm going to go look in the Downloads folder of my computer. So here I am in my Downloads folder, and you can see I have a file here called Export File _, and then the name of my class. Now, we strongly recommend that you rename this file so you know exactly what it is. If the title doesn't actually give you the information that you need, then you might want to rename it. Put in the CRN number and the term of the course and perhaps the first few words of the course title so it's going to be easy for you to find it. We also recommend that on your computer you create a folder someplace that you might name something like My Archive and Export Files, and then you will always take these files and copy them or move them into that folder on your computer so you have a single place where you can find all of your exports and archives. Now, the very last step is to once again return to the Export Archive Course page. This time, what you're going to do is delete this export file. You don't want to keep a lot of exports and archive files in your Blackboard course shell because it greatly increases the size of the course shell. And down the road, that can make it difficult to copy. So to delete it, all you do is click this little action link dropdown and select Delete, click OK. And that's it. You're done. Now, remember, if you ever need to restore your export file, do not try to do that yourself. Always contact your local college ed tech director because he or she may need to manually create a special sandbox course shell in Blackboard for you so that this can be correctly restored. And remember, You will not have access to your Blackboard course shell and its content if it is canceled or reassigned.